Hi, welcome to episode 5 of Admiral Ocean. I'm Ellie Herndon. Today we've got several items that are important for the Gulfport High family. First, it's time to update your app. If you use the Gulfport High app, it's important to make sure it's updated regularly. As new features are developed and as iOS and Android release updates, the app has to update as well. If you recently updated your device to iOS 13.1, you may find that the GHS app won't open. No worries, the app just needs to be updated to be in sync with the new operating system. If your app doesn't automatically update, you'll need to update it manually. Once it's updated to the newest version, it will work just fine. Remember, the app created and maintained by Jacoby Broadnax is your personal assistant for all things GHS. You can access the school calendar, get important announcements, view the lunch menu, check your grades, and it's the place where every episode of Admiral Ocean premieres. You can download the app free from the App Store and Google Play. Our next story is an important reminder that Gulfport High is proud to be diverse and inclusive. It's Hispanic Heritage Month. September 15th through October 15th is designated as Hispanic Heritage Month, celebrating the rich culture and history of our Hispanic American population. We have a strong Hispanic community right here at GHS. Miss Lee, who teaches the Spanish classes here along with Miss Silliers, help to bring awareness and celebration of the Hispanic culture to the student body.
The reason for this celebration is to get together with the French class, Spanish class, and the ESL class.
This Friday, October 4th, during all three lunches, the foreign language classes will participate with traditional Hispanic food, music, and dancing.
Throughout the year, we try to do a lot of activities together, but this is one that all the kids enjoy. This year, we're going to have food, music, dance, and so it's going to be really exciting. A lot of the ELL kids are going to be dressed in their traditional dance clothing and perform traditional dances from their countries. For the teachers, we're going to offer some food samples from different countries. We're going to have a singer singing in Spanish, so it's going to be really exciting. And Ms. Silliers has worked for several years. We've been talking about doing this, and it's really exciting that we're finally going to make it happen here.
This is something that we were waiting for so long. We have been doing this before with the elementary schools, but this time we have the privilege to do it over here in Gulfport High. So thank you so much for stopping by and asking about this special occasion.
And it will be Friday outside in the cafeteria and right underneath the awning, music, dance, and we'd love for you guys to come join us.
Everyone is welcome to join in and experience the festivities that are a part of the Hispanic heritage.
Gulfport High's first show of the year is Door to Door. Miss Hayes' second block is putting on the play that is a series of short stories focused on doors. The play is hilarious, touching, and unforgettable. The class is a mix of all grades, and for many, this is their first play. For some, though, they have a lot of experience.
I've never done a show with Gulfport High, but I've probably done like 20 for different theater groups and the Gulf Coast.
Well, my role in Door to Door is light design. Anything that you basically see on the stage or that happens during the show, I do, like anything that has to do with sound as well or any special effects that you see. Oh yeah, I really enjoy the show, especially with the new director that we have here at Gulfport High. Miss Hayes has really brought a lot of energy to some of the what would be seen as underclassmen classes. And the fact that the first show of the season is an underclassmen show is really exciting to see and also work on.
Admission for the play is $5 for students and $7 for adults. Come see it Wednesday and Thursday in the Admiral Theatre. If you sign up at the door, your teachers may even give you extra credit.
Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started doing the things you used to do.
Cruise on the Coast, America's biggest block party, is gearing up again. The annual event that hosts cars and visitors from all over the country will have another record-setting year. Back in August, there were already almost 7,500 classic cars pre-registered. Many more have registered since then, and 100 always show up during the week of the award-winning festival. With work schedules in school, it's not really possible to make it to all the events throughout the week. Not a problem. Beautiful downtown Gulfport is home to all the events and tops them. The 10th annual View of the Cruise, the big kickoff event, is put on by the City of Gulfport Main Street Association. All day long on Sunday, October 6th, the streets of downtown Gulfport are filled with live music, food, and hundreds of classic cars. For the seventh year, Gulfport High School students will be part of the festivities. GHS DECA students will be operating beverage stands throughout the downtown area. Proceeds from the drink sales go to Help DECA and Skills USA. And if you need something with that ice cold Coke, check out the booth run by GHS Culinary Arts students. Chef Danny's students will be cooking all day and serving up Southern specialty shrimp and grits, as well as their made from scratch cookies. So whether you're looking for the best way to catch the great cars on cruising, or if you're just looking for something fun to do, come out to View the Cruise this Sunday and show your support for your fellow admirals. You'll have a great time. Motor cooled down, the heat went down, and that's when I heard that highway sound. Cadillac setting like a tornado, 110 a half a mile ahead. Cadillac looking like it's setting still, and I caught Maybelline at the top of the hill. Maybelline, why can't you be true?
A new school year comes with new students. In the 2019-2020 school year, we welcome the class of 2024 to Gulfport High School. We are almost 2 months into school, and today we have freshman Lily Grace Horn to give us insight into freshman year. Lily Grace, thanks for being here with us today. Lily Grace, is there a big difference between middle school and high school?
Yes, there's definitely a really big difference. First of all, we have so many more freedoms, and I love just getting to pick my classes, and it's really been great so far.
What are you most excited for in high school?
Well, I made student council, and also I have my stepdad first period, so that's been really fun.
What classes are you taking this year?
I take French, art, algebra, biology, and English.
Are you involved in any clubs, sports, or organizations at the high school?
Well, I was homecoming maid. I'm on student council, and I help with Encourage to Read.
And what has been your favorite part about freshman year?
My favorite part's really just been all the new freedoms, and it's just been really great getting to meet so many new people.
Well, thanks for coming in today.
Yes.
This past Rubber Chicken Festival in the Admiral Theatre was a ton of fun. Students from several different schools came to compete, and teams were randomly made. There were even students from BVMS who participated. The contestants all did various skits which had the audience cracking up.
After, it took about a week or so to find all the games that we looked through. There were about 4 or 5 pages of games, even some that we made up ourselves. And at the end, we went with Miss Hayes to make sure that she liked the games that we were going to do. And we just went with the ones that we thought would be the funniest, would get the best laughs. And
it's just all about making sure the audience is happy and making sure that they're having a good time, and also the team's having a good time. That's really all it is.
At the end, the team Spice Girls and Pepper won both the judge and the audience votes, and they took home the rubber chicken trophy.
And then as far as like coming up with things to say, you just kind of say whatever pops into your head, and it usually ends up working if you have good people around you that will go off of what you say.
You just sort of have fun with it. That's the whole thing.
Yeah, yeah, it is a lot of fun, especially when you're surrounded by fun people, so yeah.
And you have to work together as a team. It's a little different than scripted acting, because with a script you have to memorize it, and then with improv you just have to make it up as you go along. But that's what makes improv so fun, is you don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah, and it makes people like more open. Like whenever you make a mistake, like people are going to judge you less, because like you're just coming up with it, and it's all just fun, so.
Yeah.
The first rubber chicken at our Admiral Theatre was a great success, and everyone had a great time. We can't wait to see even more hilarious improv skits in the future.
Next, how do you say short in wife? We learned in length earlier. How do you say wife? That is different. This is in length, okay? Short. Okay, I am short. There you go, Duan. Okay, I am short means I'm not a tall person, right? But Duan means this is a Duan envelope. This is a short envelope.
Duan.
Duan.
Okay, I am short.
Duan.
Okay, I am short.
Duan.
Duan.
Duan. Duan.
Duan.
Okay, I am
Duan.